Epilepsy is a group of neurological disorders characterized by recurrent seizures. A seizure is basically a sudden surge in the brain's electrical activities. It results from a disturbance in the brain's electrical balance. The brain is a complex network of neurons which communicate via neurotransmitters. A neuron can be excitatory or inhibitory. Excitatory neurons stimulate others to fire action potentials and release neurotransmitters, while inhibitory neurons suppress this process, preventing excessive firing. A balance between excitation and inhibition is essential for normal brain functions. In epilepsy, there is an upregulation of excitation and/or downregulation of inhibition, causing lots of neurons to fire synchronously at the same time. Responsiveness or excitability of a neuron is determined by the value of electrical voltage across its membrane. The closer it is to the activation threshold, the more likely it is to fire. Basically, a neuron is more responsive when it has more positive charges on the inside and is less responsive when it becomes more negative. Typically, excitation is mediated by sodium or calcium influx, while inhibition is a result of chloride influx or potassium efflux. The major excitatory neurotransmitter in the brain is glutamate. Glutamate receptors are ion channels that allow influx of sodium and calcium when activated. The major inhibitory neurotransmitter is GABA. Some GABA receptors are chloride channels. Upon binding to GABA, they open to allow inward flow of chloride. Some other GABA receptors act through a G protein to activate potassium channels, permitting outward flow of potassium. Antiepileptic drugs aim to reduce excitation. They can either act directly on specific ion channels or indirectly affect the function of neurotransmitters. Several drugs block the voltage-gated sodium channels that are essential for the depolarizing phase of action potentials. They selectively act on rapidly firing neurons and are therefore effective only when neurons are hyperexcitable. This rate-dependent action is a critical requirement for this class of drugs. It helps prevent serious side effects that could result from inhibiting normal activities of neurons. Some other drugs block the so-called transient or T-type calcium channels. T-type calcium channels open in response to small depolarizations of plasma membrane, bringing membrane voltage closer to the threshold. They are concentrated in the dendrites of neurons and play important roles in the synaptic integration. Some newer drugs seem to act by inhibiting the glutamate system. And finally, a group of drugs acts to stimulate the GABA system. Benzodiazepines bind to GABA A receptor, a chloride channel, and facilitate its binding to GABA, thus potentiating GABA inhibitory effect. Barbiturates keep the chloride channel open for a longer period of time. Tiagabine inhibits GABA reuptake from synapses. And Vigabatrin inhibits GABA degradation. Are you a fan of Alila Medical videos? If so, you will love our new Alila Academy. Based entirely on our highly effective animated mini-lectures, our courses are designed to follow a typical syllabus in each subject. Each topic is extensively illustrated and comes with quizzes to test your understanding, downloadable PDFs for a quick review, as well as images for you to use in school projects or presentations. We are known for producing highly effective animated videos that explain the most difficult concepts in record time. We have no doubt that our courses will be a lifesaver for both students and teachers alike. So do come check them out. Alila Academy. Clear. Concise, effective, with extensive visual resource. No one explains like Alila does.